Hello. In this video, I would like to give you some details on how to best troubleshoot the Wi-Fi connection between your iPad or iPhone and your ADL in-flight weather device. So, due to the iOS operating system and some settings which constantly change, this is an area where there's quite often some issue with the configuration and so on. And there's a document on the website which lists all the items you can look for, and this video is basically an illustration on how to do this. So now you see the ADL Connect app, and we are in a quite typical situation for a Wi-Fi problem. So at the left top of the screen, you see Wi-Fi ADL Connect waiting and connecting, and that's switching back and forth. So this means actually the ADL Connect app is trying to communicate with the ADL device, but it cannot exchange meaningful data. So this does not mean you have any problem with the satellite. So sometimes people search for the satellite cable and antenna and so on. Those areas can also be the source of some issues, but if you see those messages, it's most probably an issue between your iPad or iPhone and the Wi-Fi connection to the ADL device. So we go through the obvious steps you can take at this point. So we have this message, and then we switch over to the general settings of your iPad or iPhone. And we make sure that we are connected to the ADL Connect Wi-Fi. So here we see there's a little blue check mark right next to the ADL Connect, and we make sure that there, just for demonstration, sometimes the iPad simply does not want to connect, and then you can basically switch off the Wi-Fi for a few seconds, switch it back on, and then it will re-establish the connection. If you have multiple devices connected, sometimes I have seen a case where you had to disconnect all the others and then simply reconnect them all. You can connect multiple devices, but in rare cases, you have to re-establish this connection too. So to completely disconnect, you can either switch off the Wi-Fi, or you can press on the little I next to the Wi-Fi name and then press the Forget This Network. So we can do that for this test. Now, the Wi-Fi is no longer connected and it's just listed with the other networks. Sometimes also to force the iPad on relisting all the available networks, you also can switch it off and back on, and then it does a new search for all the Wi-Fi networks if it's not available. So this is the first step, and you might have a good chance that this already solved the issue. So we reconnect to the ADL Connect Wi-Fi, and we can switch back to the ADL Connect app and see if that solved our issue. So most of the time it will. So for example, now you see the Iridium and GPS indication. So that means that you have meaningful data exchange in the between the ADL device and your iPad, and the connection is fully working. But there are a few more steps if that simple first step does not help. So the next step is basically to get rid of all your background apps. So the easiest way to do this is basically to open, double click on the home button, and then to push all the apps you don't need out of the screen to the top. So you only have the ADL Connect app, and I have the audio recorder for this video still running, because the background apps sometimes they can cause issues. If that does not help, you can also try to switch off your iPad completely. So you will have to press on the power button quite for a while, and then this switch off message appears. I'm not going to do it right now, but then you can switch it off. It will completely power down, and then you can, with the power button, you can switch it back on after maybe 10 seconds or so. And then that resets the iPad completely. You can also reset the ADL device simply by usually cutting the power supply. So you might have a circuit breaker or a switch in your plane, or you can simply pull the power plug from the cigarette lighter and then switch it off and then switch it on a few seconds later. So if that does not help, the next step is to look for all the security settings of your iPad. So you go in the general settings again, and then you scroll down on the left side until you see the ADA Connect app. You select that, and now on the right side you can see all the security settings for the app. And the app will need a certain number of settings so it can operate properly and also communicate with the Wi-Fi. So here you see the configuration which works. So the location should be on always. It also works on the while using the app setting with some limitations. Also, the precise location must be activated. Then we look at the next one. The contacts are not so important. That's for the SMS messaging only. But the local network access is very, very important. So that must be enabled. And we also need the mobile data so you can do internet downloads. So those settings are very important. If those are not properly set, there will be issues with the app. So just for the demonstration, I'm, for example, going to switch that to never. And I'm going to switch over to the ADA Connect app. And you can see now it's, for example, it's going into offline mode because it can no longer, the Wi-Fi is also linked to the location authorization, so it can no longer properly communicate. If we also go on the config page and scroll down a bit, we also see here that it can no longer read the current Wi-Fi name. It just says none. And so the whole communication over the Wi-Fi is not working properly. So I'm going to set it back to always, the way it's supposed to be. We can switch back to the ADA Connect app. Wait a moment, and now we see the connection is back there. I scroll down, we see it can detect the name of the current Wi-Fi ADA Connect, so that is all working. So those are the most common issues, but there are a few more advanced settings you can check if you have some issues. So I switch back to the general settings of the iPad, and I scroll to the privacy section, and there you see the location service, and that's supposed to be on. If you switch it off, I do it right now, the ADA Connect app will not be able to communicate with the Wi-Fi. I know it's not so logic that this Wi-Fi is so linked to the location service, but that's a privacy setting, and that's basically Apple's choice to do so. So you have to enable the location service to make it work properly. And the next thing is to make sure you have no VPN, virtual private network, enabled. So here I don't have one, but it could be that you have some virtual private network and you have to deactivate it before you can connect with the ADL device, because else all the network traffic is going into the VPN network and not going to reach your ADL device. So I hope this short video helps you to debug any Wi-Fi issues. If you have any advanced issues, just send an email or call and we can figure it out. Thanks a lot for watching and fly safe.